When it comes to achieving certain flavors out of your beer, your yeast, grains, and hops can take care of that for you. But sometimes they need just a little bit of help. What's up, everybody? Just Brewing here. Welcome back to the home brewery for another grain to glass video. Today we're gonna brew a chocolate porter. This is a recipe that I've done about three different times now with a few different variations on how I'm adding the chocolate. But this time we're gonna be making a tincture. This is the first tincture that I've ever made. And we're gonna get to that later on. But if this is the kind of content that you like, make sure to hit the like button and subscribe if you haven't already. Let me know in the comments what other beers that you're trying right now so I can get a little bit more inspiration on some brews that people wanna see, beers that people are drinking, beers that people wanna see brewed. So let me know in the comments. Let's go ahead and get right into brew day. For this chocolate porter, our base malt is gonna be Maris Otter to give us a little bit of nuttiness, and Turo to kind of balance it out a little bit while also saving me a little bit of money in Maris Otter. We're gonna go with pale chocolate malt for a little bit of chocolate flavor in the backbone, and midnight wheat for some color without any roasty flavors. This is gonna be a two-step mash. The first step is gonna be pretty typical, 45 minutes at 148 degrees Fahrenheit. This is gonna give us most of our fermentable sugar. And the second step, 15 minutes at 160 degrees, this will leave over some unfermented sugar, resulting in a slightly sweeter, slightly fuller bodied beer. I'm gonna add in about a handful of flaked oats, mostly because that's the rest of it, but it's also gonna give us some head retention and a little bit of oatiness. We get it to a boil and we're gonna be following the on-screen hop schedule. The single hop in this is gonna be East Kent Golding. This is gonna give us some mild earthy flavors, a little bit of pininess as well. This will help balance out the chocolate a little bit. At the end of our boil, we chill it, get it into a sanitized fermenter, aerate, and we pitch White Labs British Ale Yeast. This yeast can give you some cherry esters, but I'm gonna ferment this at 66 degrees so that it's a little bit cleaner while also still preserving the slightly fuller bodied mouthfeel that I'm going for. At the end of brew day, I'm going to make my tincture following the steps on screen. I'm also going to link a better article in the description if you want a little bit more information. I'm gonna be using Tito's vodka. This is a local vodka out of Austin. I'm going to cover my cocoa nibs in the vodka, shake it up to make sure everything is covered, and I'm gonna leave it on my counter and shake it every single time I go by for about a week. After that, I strain out the actual nibs and pitch the liquid right into the keg as fermentation is finishing up. And here it is, the chocolate porter. It's a strong brown color with toffee colored foam, and it's teetering the line between the porter and stout. On the nose, you get quite a bit of chocolate, some pine, and that's exactly what it tastes like as well. There's a little bit of heat as it closes out, and it's a medium bodied beer with a little bit of sweetness, but there's actually, it gets quite hot on the end, and I think that might be from really the vodka from the tincture. This was the first tincture that I've done, and I mean, I think it went well, all things considered. There were no problems, no hiccups, and it smelled absolutely amazing when I was getting this into the keg. But now that it's been in the keg for a while and it still tastes great, when it finishes, there's just what feels like alcohol heat, something reminiscent of something like an imperial stout, just what I can only equate to is alcohol heat. I didn't get that in the other times that I've added cocoa nibs, but I've never added vodka right in, and there really wasn't that much that I added. I only added enough to cover the 4 ounces, and I still get quite a bit of that heat, and it's not bad, but it may be unwelcoming if you're not expecting it. A few weeks ago, once my cinnamon roll porter kicked, I have been really on a dessert pastry beer kick, so that was kind of why I went into the chocolate porter. Up next, I may do another pastry, what is that? I really want to do another one, so let me know in the comments if these are beers that you like, these pastry. Oh, I said it right that time, wow. Next time I brew this beer, if I do decide to do another tincture, I may use a different vessel, maybe see if I can get less vodka in it, but still enough to cover the cocoa nibs going in. I may also consider a couple other things. I mean, the beer is really, really good as is, but maybe a little bit more sugar on the end to kind of help. That way it's a little bit more sweet, or maybe even adding vanilla, I think would be a really good addition to this beer. Either way, we'll see. Thanks for viewing. Just Brewin'.